Hello, next we're going to talk about the distance formula. The distance formula is distance equals rate times time. This is for any unit of distance. So if we used miles for distance, we would use miles per hour for the rate. Sometimes we think of rate as speed. And t is for time. So when we work through a problem involving the distance formula, we're going to start by listing out the different pieces we have. So the first problem, a car travels 280 miles at the speed of 70 miles per hour. Notice miles per hour, we use a division bar, so that means miles divided by hours. So we have 280 miles. Miles talks about our distance. Speed is my rate. So my rate compares miles to hours in this case. And how long does the trip take? So how long is asking what the time is. So if I list out what I have here, I have my distance. My distance is 280. And I have my rate, my R, is 70. And I'm looking for my time, T. So if I plug my values into the equation, distance 280 equals my rate times time. So two variables next to each other mean that we multiply. So if I have a t sitting over here by itself, it means that I need to get it alone. To do that, I need to get rid of the 70. The opposite of multiplying 70 by t is dividing. So I'm going to divide both sides by 70. My 70s cancel. If I have 280 divided by 70, I have a common zero I can cross off and use that shortcut. Then I have 28 divided by 7, and that equals 4. So 4 equals T, but now I have to see what my unit is. So up here I measured miles, and I measured miles per hour. So that the unit here is going to give me a hint at what my time should be. 4 hours. Let's try another one. The next one says a car travels at 70 miles per hour for 3 hours. How far does it go? So we're going to start by breaking it apart. We have 70 miles per hour. We have 3 hours. I shouldn't put a box around it until it's what we're looking for. How far does it go? So my miles per hour is my rate. My 3 hours is my time. And how far is talking about distance? So I'll list out all the different pieces. My distance is 70. Oops, sorry, my distance is unknown. My rate is 70. My time is 3. So let's plug these into the equation. Distance equals rate times time. Distance is my unknown. Rate is 70. And time is 3. To solve this, I simply need to multiply 70 times 3 to get 210. So my distance equals 210. To look for units, I look back to the problem. Looks like we're measuring in miles. That's a distance. So my answer is 210 miles. Now, along with this, it's worth mentioning that sometimes we need to solve an equation for one of the variables in it. So let's take a look at that. We can also solve problems if we just manipulate the equation. So even if there's no numbers in here, if I want to solve this equation for R, for my rate, it means I want the R alone on one side and everything else on the other side. So if we think about the rules of algebra, and we want to get it so that the R is all by itself, we need to get rid of the T, right? So right now we're multiplying, so to get rid of the T, we have to divide. If we divide by T, my T's cancel. But if I do it to this side, I must also do it to this side. When I rewrite this, I have d over t is equal to r. If I was solving a problem for rate, I could then just plug my values in here. let's say the distance was 210 miles and the time was 7 hours, I could simply divide these two then. In some cases, people prefer to manipulate the equation and then plug values in rather than using the algebra. I hope that helps. Goodbye.